It's Tech Tuesday, and this morning we're learning all about the brand new iPhone. Apple set to unveil the new phone, plus a host of other gadgets like an Apple TV and a new Apple Watch. Here to give us the inside scoop is our tech expert, our friend of the show, Jennifer Jolly. She's joining us from the OAK, Oakland, California. Good morning, Jennifer.
Good morning.
It's very early where you are, so we appreciate you getting up with us. And, you know, Jen, you've been to every iPhone unveiling for the past 10 years. It's like the Super Bowl for the tech world, right?
It really is. It's like Super Bowl and the Oscars, the Academy Awards, you know, it's kind of all rolled into one. There's unmistakable excitement knowing that we're coming up to such a monumental anniversary.
What can we expect on September 12th?
We can expect the iPhone 8. We don't exactly know what they'll call it. They might call it the iPhone X or just the iPhone, but we can expect a bigger phone with more screen real estate. So we call that, you know, edge to edge to edge. The glass front will go all the way, kind of like what we're seeing with the latest Samsung phones. There's been a lot of talk that you'll be able to unlock the phone with your face, facial recognition. That's not new. Other phones have done it, but they've had a lot of problems. Like you could use a photograph to unlock the phone, or my daughter's phone would unlock the phone instead of my face. So it'll be interesting if they come out with a few big kind of flashy new tricks of the trade, if they've handled and managed and thought about some of those issues that other manufacturers have had in the past.
All right, so what it comes down to is, what's the price of this bad boy, Jennifer?
Well, I paid $1,000 for the 256-gigabyte iPhone 7 Plus that I have right now. So there's a lot of talk of a new iPhone Pro of sorts that will come out with a $1,000 price tag, probably without so much storage. We're going to, you know, expect to pay a fortune. Hopefully we'll see some changes in battery life. And I really want Siri to work better. And for that, you know, we'll save a lot of money over the year.
All right. Lastly, Jennifer, Apple's also set to announce the new Apple TV and an Apple Watch. Can you tell me quickly about those?
Yeah, Apple Watch, we're hoping to see a version that will work as a phone without your phone. So it'll work on its own with some built-in RAM, kind of a little mini computer of its own. And then for Apple TV, you know, they haven't really done anything extraordinary or revolutionary there. So we're hoping to see something new, something different. We know that they've really invested a lot in their own creation of content, like sort of every other company in the world. We know that they'll be updating their hardware with 4K support, but we hope to see something a little more robust in the world of, you know, kind of catching up with Amazon Echo and Alexa capabilities.
JJ from the OAK, Jennifer Jolly, thank you for the time.
Oh, always a pleasure. Thank you.
For all the latest info on everything tech, check out Jennifer's column on usatoday.com.